Usually when we are learning a programming language, the first message that shows to the user is hello world. But after, we learn how to say hello and then the username. So hello Leo, hello Huji, something like this. So let's show the username of the user who is pressing this button.
Okay.
How can we get the user information, the user that's using the app? Well,
we have a function called user, and we can use that for getting the email of the user, the name of the user, and the image of the user.
Okay. Let's use that just to see how it is. That's a good thing to learn.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. So if we go back to the button, we can now, instead of say hello world, we can say hello and the name of the user. So let's
make it easier. Let's show the name of the user in a text here. Okay. Then we add to the button.
All right.
Okay. But one question. I didn't log into my app. So right now, how does it know that I'm the user who is using the app? Do I have to do a login screen or not?
No, of course not. Since you are inside of a tenant, inside of an environment of an organization, you already have this mechanism of authentication. So I don't see much sense of making login screen on powerapps.
Yes, doesn't make any sense. And if you are thinking about having one email and giving to more people and doing a login screen, you are totally wrong, because that's out of Microsoft's rules. And every user needs to have its own account. Powerapps is for users who are inside a company and they have their own license, their own Office account.
Right.
Yes. So let's show the username, user email, and user image, just to show how the person who is learning how to use powerapps can do this and using their apps. Okay, here in the insert tab, we have the label element. So the label, it's just a text label we added here, and it has the text in here in its text property. So first thing, let's just rename. For label, Microsoft says we need to say LBL, and then the name we want to do. So in this case, username. Now here in the text property, let's get the username. How can we do that? So you mentioned the user function, right? User.
Yeah, there's a user function. And now you need to
open the parentheses.
Open parentheses and just close the parentheses.
Okay, just close the parentheses. Okay, nice. It gave an error. What's going on?
And if you see there where it's written data type on the right side, you can see that we have a record, right? So the label needs to display text and not record. To access this record, we just place a dot in the end of this function.
Okay, dot.
And now we can access the fields, which are those appearing there, email, full name, and image.
Right. So the user, when I type user, close, open, and close the parentheses, it will give us a record with three properties. That's the email, full name, and image. In this case, I'm going to get the full name.
Yeah.
So it just gave me my name here because I'm the user logged in and using the app. Okay. Let's see. Let's get my email. So I'm going to Control C and Control V this label, copy and paste it. I'm going to put email in here. So it just showed my email. This email I don't use. So if you email me to this email, I won't see. Okay, and also it says we have the image. So we are going to go to Insert, Media, Image. And here, let's add user, again, user, open and close parentheses, dot, image. And I'm seeing my user image.
Wow, that was easy.
Yes. Okay. Here in the image, we also have properties. We can change, for example, the border radius, put 180 and have a circle. Uh-huh. In the text, we could make my name bolder. So I'm going to select bold here, and center it and do a lot of things. Mm-hmm. But now we know how to get the username. That's in this case is user.fillname. Mm-hmm. And we want to edit this to the button action. Okay, so we want to write hello Kujima instead of hello world. So how can I put my name in here? If I just put user.fullname, mm-hmm. let's see what's going to happen. Just put inside the string. I'm going to click here, prepare the sounds. It's going to show use hello Kujima. Let's see. Just showed user.fillname. Something is wrong. Why didn't it show my name here?
Yeah, because we have to separate things, you know, inside of the double quotes, we are using a string.
We just messed everything. Okay.
Okay. We have a string, or let's say just text, right? That's why mm-hmm. we're using double quotes. And if we want to have some variable or any other value that is not static, we should use this outside the quotes.
Okay, so I need to get this mm-hmm. removed from here and just add after the quotes, mm-hmm. right? But I need to tell the app that I want to join those to concatenate.
Right.
So there is this symbol here, the mm-hmm. ampersand that concatenates strings. Yeah. That's one way to do. So now we have hello, my name, and we have the exclamation marks in the end. So let's concatenate again mm-hmm. and add the exclamation marks to the end of this string.
Nice.
Okay, so let's see now. I'm going to hit play. And just showed hello, Kujimar.
Hey. Well done.
Great. Okay, the hello world for Power Apps is done.